It's unreal. It is really unreal.
A violent, chaotic scene are what Cleveland police were called to on Friday night. When officers arrived, they found tragedy that no one should ever have to witness.
Made entry into the home and indeed cleared it and found that there were five people that were shot.
Those that call Mack Court their home simply could not believe what they were seeing.
It was chaos. There was, the whole street was, had police cars. They taped off from my driveway across and down there to that next house over there and all the way across here. No one was allowed up and down the street or nothing.
On Saturday, the Cuyahoga Medical Examiner's Office confirmed that 16-year-old Jaden Baez, his 34-year-old mother, Angelique Gonzalez, and her father, 69-year-old Miguel Gonzalez, were all killed by the shooting. An 8-year-old girl and her 48-year-old father were both critically injured and rushed to the hospital.
I can't even tell you. I literally cried all night. Like, it's devastating. I have kids of my own, so it's, and the little girl played with my little brother.
Neighbor Ashley Green says she had known all five of the victims involved, describing the family as peaceful and kind. She simply is devastated for their loved ones impacted and all who had to witness the aftermath of the Friday night shooting.
It's something you don't ever want to see. Like, you're, I'm sure people that don't even live around here, you know, like, hearts dropped.
On Saturday, Fox 8 learned that a 41-year-old Cleveland man is now behind bars at a Cuyahoga jail under investigation in connection for the crime. Investigators are still trying to identify the exact motive of the shooter, but they do know that he was the son of 69-year-old Miguel Gonzalez and brother to 34-year-old Angelique Gonzalez, both tragically killed. Charges have not been filed against the suspect, but they are expected soon.
You want to know what makes him tick? What's going through their head? I mean, what conspired for them to do that to their own family?
Brad Hamilton, Fox 8 News.